echo what you just said about, first of all, the committee's capacity to keep an eye on all of the other issues that you just mentioned, but certainly the appropriateness of our taking up this issue today. And I want to salute the witnesses. I thank them for their time. It has been a long day, but the testimony has been powerful. Also want to thank our colleagues who spoke on the first panel for their very moving testimony and their leadership here in Congress on this issue and many, many others. I also want to thank the abortion care providers in Maryland that I had a chance to work with when I was an attorney in private practice. I spent many years representing them and was able to see up close, firsthand, personally, the amount of attention, diligence, professionalism, compassion that they brought to their jobs and their responsibilities. And that helped shape my perspective and commitment on this issue. I want to come back and emphasize something we've heard today. It's been sort of alluded to. I want to put a punctuation mark on it. And that is that in many respects, this is all about power. We know that the wealthy, the white, the privileged, in many instances will find their way around abortion restrictions like the ones we're seeing in Texas. That's just the way of the world. And marginalized communities, people of color will bear the brunt of these restrictions typically. That's sadly the story of the struggle of people from the beginning of time until now and probably a good way into the future. But we can do something about that. And if you connect the dots, you recognize that it is the same communities that suffer from lack of access to healthcare, to environmental justice, to racial justice at the hands of police, to economic opportunity, and now to abortion care are communities that lack political power. And it's no accident that in Texas, not only are we seeing these restrictions on abortion care, but we're seeing restrictions in the form of extreme partisan gerrymandering that's been undertaken by Republicans in that state, voter suppression efforts, which are designed to diminish the voices of certain communities. So this is all connected. And we have to acknowledge that, be candid about it, and find out ways to fight back against that agenda. We talk about choice, but there's an asymmetry here because I've heard my colleagues on the other side talk about how a choice was made to take a child to term, to have a baby. So choice is okay as long as, for my colleagues on the other side, choice is okay as long as the choice is one that they agree you should make. But if you make a different choice, the agenda is to restrict that, limit that, ban that choice. Choice is about agency. It's about a voice. It's about justice. It's about power. It's about mutual respect. So, Ms. Ross, I'd like to come back to you because your comments have been the most direct, I think the most powerful on that topic of power, agency, respect. And I'd like you to just comment on that one more time in the context of this idea of a woman's right to choose.
For me, I like the fact that we are now bringing attention to the overlooked power of women to make the choices that make sense for them and their families. Because that's what people like to overlook, that we're not just talking about people capable of becoming pregnant as if we're vessels. We are citizens, human beings with full human rights And there are people who are dedicated to thinking that we become less human or less citizens or less capable of thinking clearly when we become pregnant. But every one of these people came from a mother who was able to think, was able to actually, you know, have her rights protected. And if she didn't have her rights protected, they should have been. So I'm fighting for myself, but I'm fighting for my family, my children, my grandchild, and everybody else, because we are not going to be subhuman citizens just because somebody thinks that they have the right to tell me what I have to do in my bedroom and with my family in a way that doesn't have my family's best interest in mind.
Thank you.